morning, everybody. I hope you can hear me better this year than last year. I welcome you to the Memorial Day gathering here at Hatfield Park and Cemetery in honor of the veterans and the troops that serve our country. At this time, I'd like to introduce our guest speaker, We won't hold it against him that he was born in Winoka and now lives in Cherokee. He's safe in Alva. But he is our state representative, and he represents, I believe, Alfalfa, Woods, Major, and Woodward counties. So at this time, I'd like to introduce Dr. Carl Newton.
Hear me all right if I talk like this?
Yeah.
I mean, seriously. Yeah. I've got some notes here, and I'm going to have to, I don't think I can manipulate everything at one time, so if you'll bear with me. I am very honored to be here today. I'm very thankful to be back in Northwest Oklahoma. It's nice to be back home. You know that. And I thank you for the invite, Arden. I appreciate that very much. And it's just honored to be able to represent you in the state capitol and go down there. And one of the things we're going to talk about today is freedom. And freedom is a very valuable thing. It's not something that we want to take very lightly. And but more than anything, we want to remember these. Memorial Day has come to remember those that we have gone on ahead of us, that have given up their lives that we can be here in a free place today. And so I think it's very fitting that we realize and look at today what an impact, how different our lives would have been had those heroes never been able to do what they needed to do. How many of you guys have ever seen the movie It's a Wonderful Life? Huh? You remember the story? It's about George Bailey. His desires were to go off and to see the world, to leave his, what he called his small town, and get out of there and see the world and have adventures and do all that. And yet all his dreams seemed to come crashing down because he needed to take the responsibility to take care of his family, his community, and those around him. And it just seemed like no matter how, every time he tried to get away, he kept getting pushed back. And then he kept getting steps on every time. He kept fighting the good fight. And finally, it seemed like things were getting ahead. And then all of a sudden, it comes crashing down. He has a major catastrophe that would ruin his name, his family's name, and all that. And it pushed him to the point of suicide. He was to that point and he wanted to give it all up. And then he had the guardian angel Clarence come in and gave him the opportunity to see what the world would have been if he had never been born. Well, what I'd like for you to think about, what would our world be, our nation be, if it had not been for these fallen heroes? And I'm going to use three examples today that I'd like to use. Now, all wars and conflicts make a major difference in our lives and in our world, okay? So if you allow me this privilege, I'd like to use three of the major ones, and that would be the Revolutionary War. If we did not have the fallen heroes or those heroes that had the courage to step up, what would our world be like if we had not had the Revolutionary War? First of all, we'd still be under English rule, right? Our success would depend on our bloodline. Who are we related to? Are we related to the king? Are we a knight? Something like that. It would be based off that. We're not. Your success, your social status, all that would be based off of that. One of the things is we'd also still be taxation without representation. That's why they mainly fought that, because they were passing all the taxes on us, but we weren't able to say anything. It was also, why did we come to America? Well, because of religious persecution. We would still have religious persecution. Another thing that we would deal with is that we would never be in control of our own property and our own land and our own business. It would be only under government rule. But the because of them, we're now under our own government. We are, have our own nation. We have true freedom. We have the ability to do what we want to do. We control our future. Our own citizenry decides how we worship and what kind of government we have. And as we establish at that time, we are a government of the people, for the people, and by the people. And that's how we decided what we wanted to do. World War II, Germany wanted to be a become a superpower. They wanted to control the whole world. They wanted to take care of the overall thing. They were mainly focused on Europe at the time to have a totalitarian government. Again, it's the invasion of taking away our freedom, the tyrannical leadership, and a tyrant over them to beat them down. And if we had not had that, they hadn't really attacked the United States at that time, but we did get involved. And without us getting involved, we would have a totalitarian government over all of Europe. We would have no personal freedoms over there. And they had no respect for personal life. And what one thing, more than likely they would have invaded our own land if it had not been for us stopping it over there. I think that would be true for World War I and World War II, that they would be in our country right now. But with that, why did we get involved in World War I? Because, first of all, we stayed neutral at first, and then we were shipping some things to carriers, freighters were carrying stuff to Britain, and so Germany attacked them. But the final straw was what? When they sank a normal civilian ship. We took up for innocent lives. We respected people and cared about the people, and that's why we got involved. We kept the world a freer place. We proved to the world that we are not somebody just to be run over, and that our freedom means something to us. And so that's why we fought. And we showed that our true concern for all people. Now, World War II. I hope you guys can remember that more in your history books. We have Hitler and fascism. And Hitler was a true dictator. I mean, he was truly, you were under his rule. We would have been slaves here in America if Hitler had got his way. We'd have been under total government control. There would have been no freedom, no government. We would have been in, the government would own businesses, it would have owned your land, it would have owned your life. There would have been no ability to be, have free ability to go practice religion. And their idea of how you would get ahead is what race you were. In fact, they were trying to genocide the Israelites, the Israel, nation of Israel, the Jews. And, but due to the fact that we had the fallen heroes, these people that were willing to sacrifice their lives, stepped out on the front lines and gave their lives, we are now still, we preserved our freedom, we stopped the genocide of a people group. We also demonstrated to the world that we were the powers that a free nation could have. That the advancements that we were able to do through our own nation, through this war, showed the rest of the world what freedom can do. Our ingenuity, our technological advances, our medical advances, and then also our weaponry advances. You know, thank God for our country and the sacrifices that we need to make those. We have fought in all. We've fought totalitarianism, fascism, communism, Marxism, and then terrorism most recently. It came out as victims. I think God has been on our side. We need to remember that God is in control and lean on Him. But He is for us, and I believe that it's our freedom, our ability to fight for that. You know, because of them, we're able to come here congregate of three people to memorialize them, go home with our family, able to raise a family, have a business, be able to go where you want to, give your chances, your kids every opportunity they want to advance. But you know, we need to consider freedom is not free. It's something we got to work at every day and all the time. That's one of the things we look at when we're down there, even in our state government. But I think Ronald Reagan said it very well. Freedom is never more than one generation away from extinction. We can't pass it to our children in the bloodstream. It must be fought for, protected, and handed on for them to do the same. Or one day, we will spend our sunset years telling our children and our children's children what it once was like in the United States for men with freedom. Now, to finish up my movie, well, all you guys remember the movie ends up that even in the dark of despair, when he looked back and saw what the town would have been like, what his country would have been like. You guys remember his brother went and fought in the war, and if his brother wasn't there, these men on the aircraft would have died because a plane would have hit him. So he had an effect on the country, he had effect on his community, and he had effect on all those people around him. It made him understand what impact his life made on others. And we need to remember what impact these people that gave their lives and gave up what they gave up. You know, I saw something this morning, it wasn't part of the speech, but saw something this morning that really hit home to me today. It's talking about John Smith Manchester. A friend of mine posted this today. He said that he died in a rice field in Vietnam. And he was 22 years old. He never got to have a family. Never got to have children. Never got to see what it was like to have a man on the moon. Never knew Ronald Reagan except as an actor. Never had a Twitter account. Never had a Facebook. Didn't know what Apple was. Didn't know what Google was. Didn't know all that. All those things he missed out on so that you and I can stand here today for freedom. We can stand here and have the right to have differences of opinion. By the way, at the Capitol I have found out that not everybody agrees with me. But the idea is that we all have our opinions and we have the freedom to voice those, to talk with others about those freedoms and what we have. So, to those of you that may have lost a loved one because of war, thank you. Thank you for the struggles you. Thank you for sharing them with us. And thank you for letting them be the standards for which we all ideal to be like. For you that have served and been out there, thank you. Thank you for what you do. Thank you for your sacrifices you have made. And I know that, especially I found out this war came more real to me this year than any other time, as we dedicated the Vietnam Memorial at the Historical Center, that during the Vietnam War, we had a lot of our heroes came back and weren't respected and weren't appreciated. Shame on us. But to those, I want to say welcome home and thank you. Your service was greatly appreciated. It made a difference. Right now in the United States, I think after that transition of the Vietnam War, we transitioned about 250,000 Vietnamese into America. They made good citizens, good part of our country. Make up 1.1 million citizens, one of the larger people groups now. in America. But if it hadn't been for them, they would have been killed. So thank you for those sacrifices. We're a better people thanks to these that I mentioned. We're a better nation because of these people. Let us resolve to stand with the next generation to protect our freedom and move it forward. Keep ourselves strong and vigilant caretakers of the freedoms that we have and not to take them lightly. And let us never take that liberty for granted. And may God help us in that. Thank you.
Thank you, Representative Newton. Once again, I'd like to thank the Boy Scout Troop 392, and the American Legion Post, apparently commanded by Scotty Cox. There are donuts and I think water and stuff down at the pavilion. Thank you, Arden and Nikki, for also arranging that. And I believe that's our presentation. Thank you for coming.